Gulf Hotels, Baggin Road.
Archer, are you clear of the runway?
Piper Archer, clear of the active, thank you. Burnie Stage traffic, Topo 87 Julius, departing runway 35, glider in tow, Burnie Stage.
Yeah, this thing weighs about 1,380 pounds, and it's running through through the air at maybe 70 miles an hour. Look at that. That was 10 knots right there. Well, talk about ferocious.
Landing on 35.
So. It amazes me that you can stay up in the air for 2 or 3 hours without an engine. It is always boggles my mind.
I think the glider record was like 3 days.
Sorry, say again?
I think the glider record to be up in the air was 3 days.
We got a guy at the airfield. He routinely goes 100 miles or more on a good day.
Wow.
So, can you tell how high above the ground we are now? Again, the field is 1,400 feet. Well, you see how we're about 3,600 feet, right?
Kind of.
The middle hand is between the 3 and the 4, so we're at 3,600 feet. You subtract 1,400 from that, you get 2,400 feet.
Okay.
Do you know where the airfield is? Look over to the right. Do you see the runway?
Yes.
Wow, it's a nice clear day.
Thank you. 04 Whiskey, 7 miles southwest of Boerne Stage. And we're going to call it the inbound. Go westbound, land on 35, Boerne.
I can't believe how many trees there are out here.
Say again?
I can't believe how many trees are out here.
Yeah. Texas is not all desert.
Corpus is all fields.
I have 4 points.
Or at least around Corpus.
We're at 4,100 feet, but I just found a little bit of lift. Not a lot of lift. But you notice it's laid above the zero line.
Yes.
All right,
we'll extend down with 5.5 plane ready to go to the test.
There's a little bit of the competition, you know?
Well, a lot of things are competition.
Yeah, all life is a little bit competitive, though.
Yeah.
Surrounding the lift, there's always sink. So if you don't turn tight enough, you go into the sink. If you ever watch buzzards, you'll see that they tend to be flying about the same size circle. That's why. If they flew a bigger circle, they'd be out there in the lift.
Thank you.
See those two big white strips?
Yep.
Now we're facing towards Fredericksburg in the north. Downtown should be almost right ahead of us now. It's a little bit hazy out there, otherwise we'd be able to see the Tower of the Americas. Can't quite. We had a heck of a lot of good sword. You can't always count on that. So now we'll fly nice and straight. Hey, you want to fly it for a bit?
Sure.
Go ahead. Grab the stick. Now, look at the airspeed indicator. See that little orange triangle thing?
Yes.
Okay. We're going to try to put the airspeed right on that orange triangle thing. But here's the trick. You don't steer at the airspeed indicator. You glance at the airspeed indicator. Now look outside at how much room there is between the horizon and the bottom of the canopy. That's the gap you want to hold. Hold that gap and you'll hold the right speed. See, now you let the gap get bigger and the airspeed now is almost 60. So bring the stick back a bit. Here we go. Now hold that gap. Hold it right there. That's where the gap was. Now you leave the gap less than it was. Okay? A little bit more. Now hold it there. Hold it there. Hold that gap there. Don't steer at the airspeed indicator. Look outside at the gap. Okay, now make a gentle turn to the right and give you a little bit of right rudder when you do it, okay? A little bit of right rudder as you make a turn to the right. Oh, that's like pretty nice. Okay, now notice the gap that, yeah, there you go. You control your airspeed by controlling that gap. Okay, so level the wings here. Let's fly straight towards that lake up ahead of us, right?
Oh my goodness, we're ready to get a full loop.
You want to go down now?
Yeah.
Okay. real good now. It just cleared up all of a sudden. Oh, you see the Tower of the Americas. Already traffic that above hotels by all the way to be fine. Oh, don't forget your seatbelt, though. I tried to get out without taking off the seatbelt, and it doesn't work. Now I put you to work. You got to go grab the wingtip.
Okay.